right then. DD2 is installed. Spent a bit of time just updating the firmware. I've put in some settings that I think might be semi-decent based on what Fanatec and Sim Racing Garage said. Favourite car. So, oh, that doesn't feel right. Save all my settings. Hang on. Recalibration required. 450 degrees. Gonna have to recalibrate this in the game. Possibly. No, actually, it's right. No, let's just do it again. So I could have it on reduced force or impart, but I'm not going to have that. I'll see how it reacts. But it's 25 newton meters and strength at 6, which is equivalent to the max force 56 newton meters. It's what Fanatec suggests as a benchmark for iRacing. So I might need to adjust the strength. The wheel force is fixed because that's just the max of the wheelbase. But give it a go. Just save my FanaLab game profile. Just amend that if we need to. Yeah. Yeah, maybe. At the end of the last video, I drove for 3 minutes, but I had the wrong firmware, hadn't updated any of the settings, and nothing was ready. So this will be fine. Although I've got. Is all my sound working? It wasn't working yesterday. Yeah.
Pit lane speed limit is 80 kilometers per hour.
Oh, it feels heavy. It feels really heavy. Yeah, no, it's too heavy. It's far too heavy. Can't move the bloody wheel. Hang on a second, we're missing to get the old no, all that. There we go, the force feedback bars on the bottom as well. There. It's not gonna get anywhere near clipping. That's ridiculous, I can't feel it. It's too heavy, can't feel anything. Well, I can't feel anything, I can feel too much. Right. Let's try this. 2 fair, I couldn't have done that whilst I was out of track. Oh no, I couldn't. Okay. Can reduce it in the panel lab rather than on here, which might help. We'll see. feels really light. I don't know. Help if I knew where I was braking. Feels a lot smoother, that's for sure, but I turn the force feedback interpolation on because this is, should be it, and it's like raw jaggedy form. So I had it on 3, I'm going to stick it on 1. This is a really flat track actually, this might not be the best. Maybe I should do Zolder. This track's really flat. You're not gonna feel very much. Let's do Game disconnected. Bye. I need a few more bumps and jolts. Undecided. This is one of those things you're only really going to notice a difference after you test it for a long period of time, I think. Feels different. It's just difficult to tell whether that's better or worse.
Hello, game on. Double check your car setup.
Let's try as is. Right, linear interpolation 1.
Inline speed limit is 60 km/h.
Yeah, that's a bit more bumpy. Oh my god.
Yep.
Oh, the curbs feel better. The curbs have got a bit of wobble in them. Which you never really get that before. Actually getting a really slight little... Ow. Okay. So the peak pour spikes are really quite high. So it's not oscillating down the straight, which is good. Smart of the wheel definitely did that. I didn't change my setup, did I? Time ran Zolder with the wrong setup. Make it a fair test. Let's do a couple more laps like this. Sure, I need the peaks to be that peaky. I can dial that down a bit. Oh. Just don't need that much of a shock to know what the car's doing. Powerful, power-wise anyway. Speed-wise maybe, but not. Doesn't need to be that strong. So this my arms at this setting my arms will drop off. Let's finish this lap and then I'm gonna change the linearity mode, which is the big thing that everyone talks about. I'm going to switch it on, which will lower the overall force feedback but remove some of the massive spikes. can just park it on the straight, can't I? This is... Right, linearity on. Nothing else changed. This might screw up the ball speed back a bit. Because it's probably going to go really light. Yep. It's now way too light. There's no point. Let's bring us back to 6 then. Let's see what we got now. A lot of strength in that. Again, but it shouldn't be quite so severe when it peaks, I think. It's a bit too heavy in the corners. Still pretty brutal. Slide. Yeah, it's too strong, it's gonna rip my bums off. Yeah, right. Actually, what am I doing? I should get the game to suggest the level as well, shouldn't I? Do I do that? No. There it is. Right, so I'm 4.8 at the moment. Should come up with auto if I do a few laps. We'll see. So there's definitely a lot more going on. I suppose the wheel can just like change direction, like, or just alter the speed with which it's resisting a lot quicker. This mode. For a very, very, very small period of testing. It just doesn't feel quite so. It's a bit more balanced between the low and the high forces. Which is what you want, really. Got an auto suggestion coming up. Guarantee this puts it up. Oh. I haven't activated my mouse. That's annoying. I'm going to do that again. Enable mouse while driving. Thank you. Some LMP2 in a minute as well. The other wheel, see what I can make of that. zero clipping. My CSW 2.5 was the way I had it set, which is about the same weight as this. It's just clipping all the time. Scared about my first crash, to be honest. Right, the auto's come up again, let's do one more lap. So although the videos I've seen say that you either, well, obviously you either let go or you hold on, you don't do a halfway house, like half hold on. I mean, sounds good and obvious, I suppose, but let's check the see what it suggests it's going to do with that horse feedback strength. That's going to be undriveable. Oh come on, that's ridiculous. It's gone up further. Well, that's a completely useless tool. Thank you for that. I think actually, let's go 4.8. I'm going to turn up the linear interpolation from 1 to 2. Let's see what that does. How exciting! Settings management.
Lap time was 2:11.6.
Because I've got no, I've got very limited dampening on. Very limited dampening. That's a interesting. So there's loads of different settings you've got. So to try and get rid of that if you want to, but it does involve sort of slowing the wheel down a little bit, sort of compromise. It's like, do you mind that, or do you want the wheel to just be a little bit, have a little bit of natural inertia to it? That is going to reduce the force feedback, like not the strength of it, but the amount of detail that's in it, because it's just being muted by someone else over the top of it. Looks like it's gone really light now. I don't know if it's because I just drove with that light for 2 minutes on 11.
That last lap was a 148.0.
It definitely, well, I say definitely, I think I'll be more inclined to move the wheel mid-turn, like, to try and preempt the slides. Like, just going around that one, I did two sort of little mini corrections mid-corner, where it's like, I don't know if I'd have done that with this CSW. Sector 2 time is okay. That time is still rubbish. Too much. Let's get rid of that.
Was there 123.7. That's your quickest lap.
Yeah, it's definitely
sector one's quick.
Definitely feels a bit more under control when you just did give a little bit of oversteer correction mid-corner. Opposite lock or whatever, whatever the right terminology is. That's a pretty quick time. That's not bad.
You've just done a 122.6. Good lap. That's your quickest today.
That's pretty good. Stuff that lap at the end, didn't I?
That lap time was 122.7. Sector 3 is a tenth off your
next. See, think. Oh, no, this might actually make me faster. Feel a lot more. This might be a placebo effect or just sort of
sector one to 10th off your best.
First reaction, but and also I didn't really know this circuit before last week when it was on the schedule, so I have practiced it a lot more than I did when I started racing it a week ago. But I do feel more confident. I feel like if it was to start sliding on me, I'd stop it.
Sector 2 time is good.
Like almost with certainty now. Whereas with the CSW you can still occasionally get caught out. Definitely spin it in a sec. Let's just really try and push this lap. I'm gonna put throttle down a little bit too early on most of the corners.
Your lap time was at 22.7. You're now 0.1 off your best. Two times quick. That lap was at 22.0. That's your fastest lap to date.
It's not my fastest lap to date, mate. It's my fastest lap that I've ever done on this track by about 0.4. Ooh, that's exciting. What's the track condition? Let's just check I'm not being duped into it by a slightly better track condition. Nope, 50% moderate usage. So the best I did all of the previous week was a 22.4. I mean, I didn't race it that often. That is quite good, isn't it? Genuinely exciting. What I need to do, I'm going to do this, I can't do it on the stream thing, but what I need to do is I can compare my laps in VRS on this track with what I've just done to what I was doing when I did when I was racing it last week. Really interested to see the steering trace in comparison, because I reckon this will. There'll be loads more tiny movements, whereas the CSW will be more like that, and then within that there'll be loads of little tiny movements in this. Why is it at Belle Isle this week? I hate Belle Isle. Let's try the LMP2s. Let's try the LMP2s as well. Let's change the wheel. So we're going to have to do the settings again, but who cares? Be interesting. Right. Oh, you can't do that with this, can you? Oh, God. Yeah. So, somehow, do the quick release, which is not so quick anymore. And then do that. mean, I know there's been loads of chat about the flex in these things, but honestly, really? Whatevs. Right. Probably shouldn't do this, really, should I? But I'm going to do it anyway. I'm actually going to go into a proper practice session. As long as we don't kill anyone. 58 cars. I've got to go into that. There's two who's good. Just for the fun of it, really. Did I used to have for this? GT hub race. Oh, let's load it and see what happens. 50 degrees of rotation still. Okay. What's feedback? 90. Actually, let's check. Let's just modify what we had for the F3. Oh, linearity's gone off. I haven't really got a benchmark for this car in this track, do, I mean, I won't have with loads of traffic as well, but it'd just be good to get a sense of how it feels.
Has just done a 145.95.
Need to redo the controls. Left, right. I don't want a button for enter exit repair auto. Change that to escape. No, come on. Oh, oh, brilliant. Lost all my sense. Nice, that's saved. Let's just go. Holy moly. Change your settings first. Wheel force, 25. Thank you. Strength. Let's try 5. I'm tempted to tick reduce force when parked, just because it's going to get rid of that nonsense. Like nothing.
Pit lane speed limit is 60 kilometers per hour.
Is my pit limiter mapped? Ah, none of my keys are mapped. Pit limiter. That one, headlight flash. That one. Brake bias. Increase. Decrease.
That's a new fastest lap for Hoffman, 145.87.
Dash page. We do the twist. Increase. Decrease. Did that work? I don't think that worked. Increase. Decrease. Standings box. Okay, we're cool. Oh, you can feel the bumps. You can feel the bumps. Oh, that is cool.
Car approaching. Watch your mirrors.
This needs the interpolation not taking up a bit. I just felt a bit of a clicky bit. Yeah.
Car on your left. Clear on the left.
Definitely does. Interpolation, take that up a bit. Oh, Panel Labs is closed. What happened there? Saving my growth file. Right, let's just go again. Oh, okay, whatever.
Fastest fastest lap for Hoffman, 145.40. Had a black flag. We'll need to come into
the black flag. They caught us speeding on pit road. We have a stop and go penalty.
Clear on pit exit, you can push now.
I do think this wheel is going to make all the difference in the long high speed corners. Where there's a danger of oversteer. I just think it's going to be easier to keep it. Just have a bit more
slow car ahead.
Confidence
car ahead.
That you've got the edge of grip and you'll get it back if you lose it. And that has to make you quicker. Too heavy. That's too low, surely. Thank you. feel like in this car I might need a bit more centre downwind or something. But hang on, I'm going to try what? Try what Barry suggested.
That puts you 2.5 seconds off the pace.
Zero.
That lap was a 147.88.
They're not actually supposed to do anything. But...
in front lap time is a 147.74.
Slow down. You got a penalty for cutting the cord.
Gave the grass a fair old wallop and inches out.
Car right. Keep to the left. Clear.
I don't feel like I've got this one in the sweet spot. Yet. Try taking off the linearity. So probably gonna make it quite heavy. This might get cut short in a minute. Oh, God.
Black flag. We'll need to come into the pits to serve the penalty. Take care, there's a car approaching.
This is now really heavy. Crank up the interpolation to where Barry has it and see what happens. 7. There we go. Just too much. Maybe if you have all the dampening effects on it, it's not so bad, but why anyone would drive on this? And mind you, Barry's settings were on the DD1 and on the DD2, so there's a bit of a difference there, but even so. Could just drop the overall force feedback. Let's just try that. This might be better. Oh God, no, I've got nothing now. To 50%, that's probably a little bit drastic. Quite relaxing. Just can't do very much. Drop my fingers.
We need to watch these track limits.
For sure, the amount of tuning you can do on them is quite high, because all these sets are making a massive difference.
beyond.
I'm inclined to agree with the people who say that the linearity mode's better. Just this isn't too bad. Like, it's not light. It's not too heavy in the corners. It loads up. You know, it's a pretty high speed turn, but unbearable. You clobber a curb. Going through a chicane, it's like, phew. Can't stop it moving. You don't need that horse. It's not making you, that's not going to make you go any quicker. I know it's got to go.
Track limits. This lap will be deleted. Pace. That lap was at 146.65. Bad luck, Matt. That was a big one. Are you okay?
Got it.
Let's go back to what we had it before. So linearity on at 90%. I think I preferred that.
Got about 5 laps of fuel left.
Track's clear. Push, push, push.
This is
feels pretty good. Can't rip my arms off over these bumps. Should really try this wheel with the Dallara IR01 thing. That one really took some paces. So I think it is at least.
You have about one lap of fuel left.
Lap in the session. The lap time was 1:46.13.
There you go. There you go. That one needs a bit more work. It's definitely got potential though. Just need to work out how to unlock it. Flip the curve there like a lemon. If I hadn't done that, I probably would have got to the 145s maybe.
exit off there wasn't great. Nice. I'll be able to try the F3 now. I don't like Belal the track this week. Anyway, all good.